We're taking the eco mats, and there's one leaning against the container over here, which is going to use as a demonstration after lunch, and the PGA, and combining the two. So the PGA is the aggregate underneath the mats. And the applications we're looking at here as trailhead kiosks. It's a high use, high concentrated, you know, people standing in that area with a kiosk like this. A lot of kiosks have roofs on them. And we use, this is a 3/8 minus aggregate that we typically use on these accessible trails. With water flowing, you get this drip line and a trench that occurs in pretty short order. So we're excited about the idea of the mat being used in front of a kiosk to take that impact of people, traffic, you know. And then we're going to walk out here in a few minutes. We've also are setting up a picnic area using the mats. And the other place that they could be useful for accessibility purposes is in association with a bench. Having a mat set down and then a bench fastened, and that allows for the mats are just the right size in terms of length that someone in a wheelchair can sit next to the bench on the mat. So there's accessibility sort of playing into all of this with these mats. And right now, these are the areas that we're seeing on trails where, or recreation really, where these mats can be applied. An accessible picnic site, picnic table. And essentially you need 4 feet of clearance around a table. And Mike, I think we talked about the table is going to be about 10 feet long. Yeah, by about 5 feet wide. And this is, each mat is about 40 inches wide. Okay, so we got about 160 inches of width. And we have 230 inches or so in length on this pad right here. And so the process was, you can see this was excavated. This is an old beach, so it was pretty much pure sand in here. And then we put down a 4-ounce non-woven geotextile, then the glass came in, and then we created that. And this whole pad pitches at 2% in this direction and in that direction. That's the low corner, this is the high corner right here. And that's essentially for drainage. And that's the design standard for things like asphalt and concrete for draining water. So we use that. The other thing we did was we perforated the mats, as I mentioned earlier. And what I've got here is a bucket of water, which we're gonna throw on this.
Ooh, over here to the high side.
So you can see between the perforations and the joints, that water just disappears. And because there's 5 to 6 inches of glass underneath this, that water just disappears down in. And we have the geotextile there as a separator so that the glass and the sand don't intermix underneath. Now this is kind of an unusual setting because of the sand that's here. Normally, you know, throughout most of New England, we're going to have, you know, more till soils, poorer soils, and so it's still going to allow for that water to disappear.
Way more Anybody notice what's different about this mat compared to the ones out of the picnic and bench area? Yeah, down in corners.